You're a proud and happy owner of Canon EOS M50. You had it for a while, you've been playing with it for a while, and now you're ready to move on from automatic video mode to a manual one. So, how you shoot it with EOS Canon M50? All is coming up in today's video. For those watching my channel first time, my name is Zdeňka Kaderová. I work as a photographer, I'm a former model and a few other things. I make tutorials and fun vlogs, so don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Only a few months ago, I had the very same question. How do you shoot video manually? I found quite a bit of tutorials online explaining just that, but I thought, cool, but how do you actually do it? So let me grab the Canon EOS M50 and let's do this together. I am back at the camera, set up my Canon 5D Mark III, and I gotta tell you, it took me about 25 minutes to set this up. I just hate manual focus, there's no autofocus. This is the goal, this is, has autofocus and it's so much easier, you just pop it up and go. No more trouble like that. Anyways, I am back. Automatic mode is easy. Just make sure that the dial is set to video and turn on the camera. Done. The problem you are going to get is that when you shoot a scene where lighting conditions change, the footage will be going brighter and darker depending where the focus will be at that moment. To have really nice cinematic footage, you will need to switch to manual mode. First, I'm going to show you how to set that up inside and interior. And once the weather clears up, hopefully tomorrow we'll get some sunny day, I'll take you outdoors. First, you need to decide what frame rate you're going to shoot at. I'm going to shoot in the standard one, which is 24 frames a second. But first, you need to actually get out of the automatic mode. So press Q, choose mode, and hit the M, set OK. Now let's press Q again and let's get into the frame rates. Now if you see 4K in 25p and FHD in 50p, that means you need to change something again. Go to manual, function settings, press OK. And at page number 3 you see video system. That means that you are set up on PAL. Now change that to NTSC. Close the menu. So now let's press Q again and look at the frame rates, and now you can see 4K in 24, FHD at 60, FHD at 30, FHD at 24, and HD at 60 frames a second. So let's press Q button one more time, and you have choices 4K at 24p or FHD at 24p. I keep it at the FHD. Sometimes if I want to do 4K B-roll, then I press the 4K button, but I'm gonna get that crop. So if I'm filming myself, I just press FHD at 24 frames a second. Next, you will need to set up shutter speed. Now here you have to remember, if you don't double, you are gonna be in a big trouble. So double trouble. Since I'm shooting at 24 frames a second, double would be here for me an option, 50 frames a second. If you shoot slow motion at 30 frames a second, you will set up to 60. If you shoot slow motion at 60, you will set up at 120. And if you shoot the very super slow motion, 120 frames a second, you will set it to 240. Simple, right? Next, you want to set up the aperture. Now, if you're shooting yourself, or if you're shooting an object where you want yourself or the object very, very nicely sharp and the background nice and blurry, you want to go with the number all the way down. So I'm shooting at my lens 15 to 45 millimeters. So I'm going to hit the F button and I will go all the way down to F3.5. If I am filming, for example, a group of people, I increase the number a little bit to usually 5.6. Then if I want to see even more sharpness in a large scene, then I go even higher. Last thing you need to set up is your ISO. To get the brightness just right. Now I have ISO 100 here, obviously it's dark, so I have to move it a little bit higher And if I look at 200, it's okay. But if I go to 400, it will be above right in this situation. Unfortunately, the higher ISO you're going to set up, the more grain you're going to get in your footage. Just like I promised you, we are now outside where it's a lot more light. And let's start with setting up a frame rate. I'm gonna be shooting a standard video, which means I'm gonna be shooting at 24 frames a second. Next, I have to set up shutter speed. And since we are shooting at 24 frames a second, we already know I have to set up 50 as my shutter speed. Next, I'm going to set up my ISO because it is so bright. I know automatically I'm gonna go as low as possible, which is ISO 100. To make the aperture right, I have to go a bit higher. Now, I actually had to go all the way to 6.3 for this one. If the sun would be out, I know I would probably have to go even higher. Here I forgot to mention something. I am so used to setting up everything by simply looking at the screen, but I totally understand that if you are new at this and you are very unsure if the brightness is correct, you can actually pull up histogram on the screen in this camera. Very simply, hit the menu, then go to function settings, find page 4 where you see shooting info display, press that, then you go to screen info settings and choose number 3. Press OK. Now you see the histogram on the screen. And now you have to make sure that all the data are kind of in the middle full. Now back to aperture. So how do you set up that sweet sharp object and beautifully blurry background? How do you bring the aperture down on a very, very bright sunny day? In my case, it would be f3.5. Well, for that you will need ND filter. It looks like this, and it kind of works like a camera sunglasses. So yes, if you are doing video outdoors during a bright sunny day, you will need ND filter. You should have it in your camera bag all the time. And to make it easier for you, I actually linked few ND filters in the video description below. So check it out. There are a few choices for 15 to 45 millimeter lens. So you will need 49 millimeter ND filters. And I also listed few choices for 22 millimeter lens, which would be 43 millimeter ND filter. Well, I promised you to show you some slow motion as well. So here's a B-roll shot at 30 frames a second, slowed down to 80%. And here you have B-roll shot at 60 frames a second, slowed down to 40%. And finally, here is super slow motion, shot at 120 frames a second, slowed down to 20%. Well, that's it for today's video. I hope you liked it. Please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for all future videos, especially when it comes to Canon M50. I have a lot more coming up. If you have any questions or comments or would like to request a video about Canon M50 on a certain topic, please write it below. You know I'm reading them all and I respond all. I'm always happy to read and hear from you guys. So again, thanks so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Ciao, ahoy.